Going on TikTok, it's your boy LS Swap Culture. Here with an update on the Chevy. It's a 91 Caprice Classic. Little bit about the car. For a lot of y'all that don't know, if you follow me on my YouTube channels, LS Swap Culture, and my biggest channel, LS Chevy Grinder, you find out that when I bought this car, it had a 305 engine in it. The engine ran, the car ran, but that 305, it was not it, you know. And everybody out there that have the box Chevy or the old school Chevy cars, y'all know these 305s, 350s, they just ain't it no more. I mean, the one I had smoked. But it ran like a sewing machine, you know? But so, you know, with that being said, I said, you know what? I got to get rid of this and just do the LS swap. So, the motor I got in the car is it's an LQ4 6.0 motor out of a Hummer. The motor still has the truck intake, as you can see. I got this air filter on here for now, but I do have a cold air intake. I promise you I do. I just had to get the car running. You know, when I got it running, the first thing I ran into was I didn't have any gas coming up to the gas lines. So what I had to end up doing was taking the 96 Impala, gas assembly, and I dropped it down in the tank. Then we was able to get gas pressure up. So, you know, after I done that, car, it cranks, it runs. You see, I got headers on here, both sides. I got good clearance. I got this bracket from Amazon. Originally, I had the ICT billet bracket, but that was not it. That wasn't gonna work because with the iron block, you know, you gotta drill a hole in it to mount the alternator. And I said, no, I'm not doing that. Well, I did do it, but come to find out when I got the car running, all the vibration, you know, it just wasn't looking right to me. And, you know, I didn't wanna be driving the car someday and all that vibration just knocked it loose and then I'd be somewhere stranded, so. I went with something better. I recommend you, if you got the iron blocks, 6.0 LQ4 to LQ9, go with this bracket right here. It's on Amazon. It's an accessory bracket for the alternator and the power steering pump, which is down here. Trust me, you're going to save yourself a lot of headache. You're going to save yourself a lot of time. And, you just get right to your build, man. Don't nobody want to slow down while they're building and buying extra parts. So that's what I'm here for, man. I'll give y'all a little more details of what you're going to be facing with the LS swap. Now, I thought I was going to run into clearance issues with my ABS. But as y'all see, my ABS is still on here. That's the power steering pump. I got at least 3 inches of space in between the both of them. So, it's not touching at all. I haven't hooked the power steering up yet. The aftermarket eBay harness to wire it up with works like a champ. I didn't have anything really bad to say about the harness. It was plug and play. I bought aftermarket coil packs. I bought the aftermarket coil pack harness. I bought new frill injectors. Let's see, what else did I get? New frill injectors. I got my stock gas rail. I got A&M fittings. 6 A&M, I believe, is what they'll connected from here to the gas tank. Like I said, I have a cold air intake for this. Matter of fact, I just showed it to y'all. I got a cold air intake, it just ain't on the car. I gotta extend the mass airflow sensor. That's in the trunk. Right here, the plumbing. I just gotta extend my mass airflow sensor, which is right here. So after I extend that, I get this to go over to the passenger side of the car, which I moved the battery from the passenger side and put it on the driver's side. So I got all this stuff, man. Just ain't on the car. You know, I know I get a lot of people saying, oh, you should do that, you should move that around. Trust me, y'all. I know what I'm doing. I build cars, what I do. I appreciate your input, though. I appreciate it. You know. Everything on this car is pretty much everything that came on the truck. The truck oil pan's still on here, but I am going to take that off. You know. I'm going to take that off. Even with me lifting the car. You know, I just want to have that peace of mind that I don't hit a speed bump and crack the oil pan. So I'm taking that off. A lot of this stuff was just to get the car running. I started building the car last year around, I want to say March. Start tearing it down. Really got it all back together around October, November. I crunk it up for the first time probably about 3 weeks ago. That would have put us about January. And now we're just putting little pieces on, man, that we need. I got an aftermarket radiator with the shroud and the fans built into it. I have the digital dash on the way from Dakota Digital. The rear end is going to be rebuilt. I have the AC still intact. I never took it apart. So, only thing we're going to do is just get the bracket to put that back on. And we're going to put it back in its factory location. How my motor is sitting, I have the aftermarket motor mount brackets, and it's in the first hole. The first hole gives you the factory position so you can use your drive shaft. I know a lot of people, they set their motor a little bit forward a little more, and then that's when you run into, you got to get custom drive shafts. I know if you run a 480, you should be able to put it in with no problem. You just might have to find, I think it might be the second slot that you can set it in that position. You should be able to line up the 408. I got a 4L60, and mine is in the first position on the adapter plate. So you got your C-clamp, you got your adapter plate. You put your C-clamp in that very first hole for the motor mount, and that's where your factory position would be for the small block. I got the truck intake on here. I'm not having any clearance issues with it. Pretty much wrapping everything up, man. I'm getting the car back together. I removed a lot of the old stuff that I didn't need. This is drive-by wire. So, you know, I got the throttle pedal from the truck. I got that welded in, did all that a long time ago. I think that's about it that I can think of. I mean, if y'all have any questions, you know what I'm saying, leave a comment below, and I try my best to answer them. But until then, man, I'm out. Peace.